Hello, my name is Keith Knuth, and this is a tutorial on the data catalog custom schemas in Infor OS. Now, Infor OS includes a robust system integration platform called ION, and ION contains a component called the data catalog that governs what data can be processed. Out of the box, Infor provides schemas in the data catalog for business object documents, BODs, which are the standard way that Infor applications interface with other apps. There should be a card popping up in the corner of this video right now to link to another tutorial I've done on the basics of business object documents in case you need it. However, some integrations you create will inevitably not be covered by the standard message schemas Infor provides. Instead, you will have to create a custom schema to support applications that have their own file layouts and formats. As you'll see, it's easy to define these custom schemas in ION, but the process varies slightly depending on the type of message you are sending. So let's take a look at how to do this. Here I am in our enterprise portal, and I've selected the ION Desk application here. And I'm in the ION Desk. I've selected Data Catalog Object Schemas. And to add a new schema into the system, I just click the big add square. The schema wizard is going to start up, and the first question it's going to ask is, do you want to generate it from uploading a file, meaning you're going to upload a file of real message with real content in it, and the wizard's going to try to extrapolate from that what the schema of the file is, or if you just want to build it from scratch. And so for this tutorial, I'm just going to choose build it from scratch. And I'm going to go on to the next step, which is object information. This is the noun name that we've talked about in other BOD videos. I'm going to call this an item feed from a point of sale system. It's going to be a comma separated file, and there's not going to be any header row in the file. Next, you can see I've already started defining some of the fields in the file. You do that by just hitting the plus button here. And you add a new field. I've defined a company, location, item, and timestamp. Each time I add a field, it's going to ask me a little bit about it, what position in the file it is, what is the data type, how long the field is, and so forth, so it can fully define the schema for this file. And then in addition to the core schema, there's some metadata, like what is the primary key, the identifier for this? And I'll say, well, it's a combination of company, location, and item that is a key to this file. And is there any field that defines a timestamp in the file? Yes. There are a few others here, a variation to in case there's different revisions of the same record coming in, and then also a delete indicator in case the file coming in is actually telling the system to delete the object out of the database. So those things are all optional metadata. And then in the end, and by the way, you can also upload a metadata file here as well instead of defining it manually. And then lastly, there's a review section where you get to see the actual schema files being generated, just in case you want to review them for accuracy. When you're done, you just hit finish. And this new object schema is loaded into the repository. However, this wizard can only be used for delimiter separated value files, DSVs, and JSON files, because those are the only ones with kind of simple schemas that you can define in this type of wizard. But back on the object schemas page, if you wanted to set up a custom BOD schema, you would do that via the import button right here. And you would import a local file with that schema already defined. Let's take a look at how that would work. So let's say that I'm going to import some expense management information. There is actually an existing BOD for called expense report is the noun to do this, but you can see it's pretty long, it's pretty complex, and maybe it's not a whole expense report I want to import, but instead just a single charge with just a few fields. That might be a good reason to define my own schema. So you can see here that the schema is going to involve two files again, an actual schema file and a metadata file. And this is the metadata file. And the layout here is shown, Don't worry, I'm going to give you a link at the end where you can download this file so that you don't have to type all this in. I'm giving it the noun name that it belongs to, and the noun I'm going to create is called expense management data, or XM data. And then I'm saying that the verbs that are supported by this noun are the following. You don't have to support all these. You could just support sync if you wanted to, but several are shown here. And then I've got to actually define the schema of this new BOD that I'm going to import. And it's a little more complex because now I have all the fields in the file, right? So again, this will be part of a sample download you can have at the end. But I'm telling it the noun name, the XM data noun, and I'm just listing out the fields that are going to be in this file. This is a pretty simple, pretty flat structure, but I wanted to give you something to start with so you can understand it. You can make this as complex as you want, but we said we needed a simple BOD here, so this is it. There's about 8 different regular fields here, from expense report number to name to country to expense type and amount. But then there's one other element here that's a restrictive simple type where it must equal one of these values, like receipt included, VAT receipt, or no receipt, so that one of these three are the only valid values, and then followed by one other string field, the country. And then I add my schema, pretty simple, traditional XSD. Both of these files are going to be zipped up, and again, I'm providing you that zip file in the end, and imported right back here in that upload screen that I showed. You click the upload button and the import button and upload that file. That is the slightly different process for defining a custom BOD schema versus a JSON or DSV. There's much more information available on this topic than I could fit into this short tutorial. So for all the details, please visit our online documentation at the link shown. Don't worry, that link is also down below in the video text, so you can just click on it and be taken there. From there, you'll want to look at the ION Development Guide in the Creating Custom Metadata section, and the ION Desk User Guide in the Data Catalog section. And if you want a sample of the actual file I imported during the demo for the BOD, just look at the link shown. Thanks for watching.